Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, I'm going to take my report ideas a step further and give you a few more. Let's check it out. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. I did a video where I talked about some report ideas and using a combination of button and bookmarks to help give your users information that they need to understand the report. So I wanted to take this a little step further. Again, shout out to Chris Hamill, who had this idea and shared it with me, and I want to share it with you. So enough of all this talking. You know, we like to do it here on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. All right, so I'm in the Power BI service. You've seen this report. This was done in the last video, so I showed you how this worked. Remember, we can have some cool slide out information. We can do inline definitions with the pillars themselves. And then we have an info panel that we can do, but I added this new button here. This is going to be another pane that you can add. So the info panel, we've got items here where we can show, you can click on these items. But what I want to show you here is more information about the report. When I click on this, we've got our different pillars here. We can define those items. The other thing I'm doing here is spelling out the actual dimensions of the data. So what's the current fiscal month? Where was the month over month comparative month? You know, that was last month or the last month to the full month. So June versus July. And then down below, we could even include other information like how was this last refreshed? Or maybe there's a version, like when was this report even last updated? The other thing, which your eyes probably went to first, and that was intentional, is the fact that I can report a bug and I can provide feedback. What? Actually getting feedback from your users for a given report. Patrick showed his thumbs up, thumbs down video where you can actually rate the report. You could even include that in this, right? But this takes it a step further to actually say, look, are you encountering a problem with the report? Or hey, do you just want to provide some feedback? Maybe you've got a suggestion for improving the report, something we need to add to the report. Go ahead and submit that. Let's see what it does. So if I just click on, let's report a bug, and it takes me to a form and I can fill out my information. I can provide a screenshot. If I save that somewhere, maybe I put it on OneDrive. I want to give the link. And so I can describe what were the steps that I took to create this problem. Then I could submit this and then the report author will get that information. And if I go back and we say provide feedback, oh, this takes me to a different form where I can just give that suggestion and maybe an optional screenshot that I want to supply to kind of illustrate what I'm talking about. Maybe it's a quick mock-up or a pointer to something. So this is a way that we can actually get that information from our users. And there's lots of different ways you could go about doing this in terms of how to collect that information. You could actually do this with a Power App integrated in the form. If you're not using Power Apps or Power Apps isn't available in your organization, using something like a Microsoft form is easy to collect that information. It's easy to spin up. And from a business analyst perspective, there's, you know, not a lot of friction here to get this up and running. The other thing that makes this interesting is it's portable, right? So in your organization, if you're not using Office 365, then, you know, use other forms or other ways. Maybe it's an Excel spreadsheet. People can just type some information in. The options are limitless there, and you can figure out what works best for you and integrate that into your report. All right, so how did I actually do this? Let's go look at the actual Power BI desktop. So again, this is what we did last time, but what I'm going to show here is I've got another bookmark here that's actually having this definitions pane open. And again, all I did was I created a background image, which has got the borders and boxes and stuff I can lay it out. So that's easy peasy. And then here, these are just buttons. If I select the bug button, if we look at actions, I'm just going to a web URL. And this is what makes it easy, right? This is just the link to the forms. It's a hard-coded link. And you can get fancy and you can do all sorts of things where maybe you have a dynamic URL, or maybe you take it to another page that has an integrated Power App. But this is just what we chose here. The other thing you may be looking at is like, wow, those buttons are pretty cool. Like, how'd you get that effect where the icon itself is there with the text and you're actually lighting it up as well. So let me look at that real quick, just as a bonus to this. If we go to style, you'll see I've got text there where it's reported bug, and I've got icon, which is my bug SVG. One thing to note is the text itself is right aligned and then the icon is left aligned. And as part of that, let's look at the hover. The on hover, what I did is, you know, I'm just choosing the font color for the text. And then I've got another image or SVG that's the same color. So it's actually switching out. I've actually got three different images here because because if I click on it, it's going to be black. If it's just hovered, it's blue. And if it's not, it's this grayish type. And I'm just using those styles to control what's being shown. So it gives that integrated look inside of the button and takes that button to the next level. So these are some concepts that you can apply. Again, I just want to get those thoughts flowing in your head about what you can do to help your users and get the information you need to make your reports even better. All right, what did you think about this? Is this something that you would maybe apply in your report? Let me know in the comments below about what your thoughts are. If you don't have any thoughts, just leave an emoji down there. Let your feelings flow. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.